agnosia, the inability to process sensory information. Often there is a loss of ability to recognize objects, persons, sounds, shapes, or smells, while the specific sense is not defective, nor is there any significant memory loss. It is usually associated with brain injury or neurological illness, particularly after damage to the occipital border, which is part of the ventral stream. Agnosia only affects a single modality, such as vision or hearing. More recently, a top-down interruption is considered to cause the disturbance of handling perceptual information. Agnosia causes loss of the ability to recognize or comprehend the meaning of objects even with intact senses. Your sensory organs are capable of perception, but your brain is not able to process sensory stimuli. The inability to see visual motion. Cannot point at external targets located outside their own body. It's getting interesting. Whether other persons, body parts, or objects, but they perfectly point at their own body parts. Lack of insight. What is this? Unable to distinguish visual shapes. Trouble recognizing, copying, or discriminating between different visual stimuli. Can describe visual scenes of objects but still fail to recognize them. A patient finds it difficult to recognize objects by touch based on its texture, size, and weight. However, they may be able to describe it verbally or recognize some kind of objects from pictures or draw pictures of them. Damage in the somatosensory cortex. Where's that? Of course, it's a link. I'm going to click on it. Auditory agnosia has been recognized since 1877. Difficulty distinguishing environmental and nonverbal auditory cues, including difficulty distinguishing speech from non-speech sounds, even though hearing is usually normal. I wouldn't want to be that person. Two types of auditory agnosia. Semantic associative and discriminative agnosia. Semantic associative agnosia is associated with lesions to the left hemisphere, whereas discriminative agnosia is associated with lesions to the right hemisphere. Don't hurt your brain. If you become agnostic? Really? See? Okay, agnosia, coined in German from Greek agnosia. Ignorance. Etymology. I'm telling you, it's interesting. Gnostic. Relating to knowledge, especially esoteric mystical knowledge. Gnosticos. Known. We're making the connection. Agnosia and agnostic are closely related. See, this is why etymology is important. Pure word deafness, auditory verbal agnosia. This presents as a form of meaning deafness. Meaning deafness. Crazy. Meaning deafness. You're deaf to meaning. In which hearing is intact, but there is significant difficulty in recognizing spoken words as semantically meaningful. I took semantics in college, semiotics, where they tried to help us understand the meaning of words, the power of language as a tool, the ability to communicate, symbolism. We're just looking at the types of agnosia. We're not even getting into it yet. Is it with a zh or with a zya? It's associated with the inability to orient parts of the body, often caused by a lesion in the parietal part of the posterior thalamic radiations. Frontal lobe, parietal lobe, temporal lobe, occipital lobe. One of the four major lobes of the cerebral cortex in the brain of mammals. Occipital lobe is positioned above the temporal lobe and behind the frontal lobe and central sulcus. Clickety click. They're separated lobes regions because they're most often separated one from another with sulci. Clickety click. Sulci. Is it agnosia?
Agnosia.
Wasn't that in British though? Eggnog.
Agnosia.
Got him!
So you can't recognize your body parts. Cerebral.
Achromatopsia.
Achromatopsia.
Difficulty in perceiving colors in which the world may appear drab or in shades of gray. Oh, that's so poetic. form of color blindness caused by damage to the cerebral cortex of the brain rather than by abnormalities in the cells of the eye's retina. It typically refers to autosomal recessive congenital color vision condition. The inability to perceive color and obtain satisfactory visual acuity at high light levels. People who do not perceive any auditory information but whose hearing is intact. The inability to locate a specific room or building that one is familiar with, as well as the inability to provide directions or how to arrive at a particular location. Aren't we all that person sometimes? This form of agnosia is often associated with lesions to the bilateral. Please, not my brain. Finger agnosia, the inability to distinguish the fingers on the hand. Form agnosia, only parts of details, but not the whole object. Heterotopagnosia, cannot point to another person's body parts, but can point at their own body parts. Where's my head? Usually a patient has a form of associative agnosia. This is where one has the ability to recognize elements of something, but yet be unable to integrate those elements together. Pain agnosia. Of course, this word came out of Dr. House, the Dr. House MD series. There's some things like this one. This is so out of the ordinary. We don't even think about these things, that people live with these difficulties to process information, and this is their ordinary life. Congenital
and analgesia.
Difficulty perceiving and processing pain. He tries to fight the girl that does not feel any pain with his own perception of pain. His emotional pain is caused by maybe his curiosity, the depth of his knowledge. Frequently, knowledge is pain, things that you're uncomfortable with. It comes to our attention that there are many people who suffer from all of these disorders. It's easy to not think about any of these things. And it's easy to know less. We should do what we can. Spread knowledge, spread awareness. Awareness will lead to better treatment, better conditions for these people that live under these circumstances. Taking this pain in, processing it, trying to make it into something better. This is the power of knowledge. The inability to recognize familiar voices, even though the hearer can understand the words used.
Bobby, how are you, son?
Who's that?
Maybe that's why I'm laughing, because this is so awkward. This is like, it's making me uncomfortable. Here in my country, they used to call old people and pretend that they're family or doctors of their family, and their family is in immediate danger, trying to coerce them to give them money to help their family. I often remember people's voices even after I've seen them just once. I remember I had a throat condition where I lost my voice. The only way I could speak was really, really low. And I called my friend. We have all these inside jokes, and he was uncomfortable. He was just laughing, and he kept on asking, "Who is this?" He couldn't recognize even my pronunciation of words. Face blindness. Patients cannot consciously recognize familiar faces, sometimes even including their own. You look at yourself in the mirror. Who are you?
Who am I?
Where's my usual face? Often misperceived as an inability to remember names. Inability to recognize text. Pure alexia involves not being able to read printed material, but these individuals still have the ability to write. Usually can read words letter by letter. They're able to read high frequency words better and faster than they can read low frequency words. Expressive social emotional agnosia. The person is unable to perceive facial expression, body language, and intonation, rendering them unable to non-verbally perceive people's emotions. Imagine though, it's not hard to imagine these days, who are we kidding? Your boyfriend just left you, why are you so happy? The inability to process visual input as a whole. Faces, bodies, objects, rooms, places, pictures, in a bit-by-bit fashion. Tactile. Impaired ability to recognize or identify objects by touch alone. The person cannot rely on visual cues to guide them directionally due to the inability to recognize objects. Excellent capacity to describe the visual layout of the same place. Patients with topographical agnosia have the ability to read maps, but become lost in familiar environments. Visual dysnosia, loss of the sense of awareness. Visual agnosia, associated with lesions of left occipital lobe and temporal lobes, inability to recognize words in speech and writing. Strokes, dementia, neurological disorders, trauma-induced head injury, brain infection, hereditary. Some forms of agnosia may be the result of developmental disorders. Please pay attention to your children. Show them how the world works. Patients who experience dramatic recovery from blindness experience significant or total agnosia. In order to assess an individual for agnosia, it must be verified that the individual does not have a loss of sensation, that both their language abilities and intelligence are intact. In order for an individual to be diagnosed with agnosia, they must only be experiencing a sensory deficit in a single modality. Treatment. For all practical purposes, there is no direct cure. Sorry, guys. See, this is what I'm talking about. It is not prominent, and there is no search for a cure. Patients may improve if information is presented in other modalities. Different types of therapies can help to reverse the effects of agnosia. In some cases, occupational therapy or speech therapy can improve agnosia. Many individuals with a form of agnosia are unaware of the extent. This lack of awareness usually leads to a form of denial and resistance to any form of help or treatment. Let's throw that in. The Kubler-Ross model. Shock. Okay, satisfaction, energy. Refusal to understand. Denial. Rejection. Resistance, inertia, argument, revolt, sabotage, anger. Catharsis, sadness, lethargy, despair, depression, resignation, lack of drive, aimlessness, distrustful, doubtful, nostalgic, acceptance of change, reintegration, and return to normal. With the little smiley faces. Oh, that's so sad. The bottom one is crying. There are various methods that can be used which can help the individual recognize the impairment of imperception or recognition that they may have. A patient can be presented with a stimulus to the impaired modality, only to help increase their awareness of their deficit. Alternatively, a task can be broken down into its component parts so that the individual can see each part of the problem caused by the deficit. Once the individual acknowledges their perceptual or recognition deficit, a form of treatment may be recommended. There are various forms of treatment, such as compensatory strategies with alternate modalities, verbal strategies, alternate cues, organizational strategies, alternative medicine, current research. There are clinical trials being done to further research for treatments at the National Institute, sounds so bureaucratic, of Neurological Disorders and Stroke, NINDS, or NINDS for short. They support research for rare diseases like agnosia. Some organizations that are recruiting for trials are using clinicaltrials.gov and give status updates on the trials. I'm trying to be sarcastic. I'm not being skeptical of the people that look for the cure. I'm being skeptical about general perception of rare diseases, as they say. Rare diseases, it's a rare disease. Who cares? That's the problem with big pharma. They always look for more profit. If they make a cure, that research was expensive. Production was expensive. These people, they're normal people. They're not going to pay thousands of dollars for a pill. This is why it's important to raise awareness and to potentially help the people that suffer from them. All right, let's see alternative medicine, because conventional medicine doesn't want to help. We turn into traditional medicine. They try to mask it, make it sound like fantasy. How were people treating before modern conventional medicine? This is not alternative medicine. This is pretty much the strategy that they suggested. Some history here. Ignorance, absence of knowledge, not knowing. LTTstore.com. What a way to kick things off, right?